Ahoy mga ka-t-shirt, it's me again, Mike V, your t-shirt guy, to give you personal development topics and IT and tech stuff. So today, we will have a new topic for our Scrum 101 series entitled Agile Manifesto. If you are interested with the topic that I mentioned, please stay tuned mga ka-t-shirt. Okay, like what I mentioned in the intro, we will talk about Agile Manifesto. Alam na natin yung basics, na-discuss na natin yung mga yung basics ng Scrum, but we wanted to dive a little bit further to what is Agile all about and what are the principles or the core foundational values of Agile. Very important kasi if you wanted to transform an institution from the traditional approach to the Agile approach, you need to change your mindset and you need to change your core values aligning to the core values of Scrum. And for us to understand the core values of Scrum, we need to talk about Agile Manifesto. For those who don't know me yet, I would like to introduce myself to you. My name is Mike Villanueva. I am a Scrum Master, a certified one in India, Philippines, and a part-time YouTuber. So before we start, I wanted you to watch also my previous video. So click nyo lang yung nasa baba for you to follow the first part. This is the second part, so it's better if you watched already the first part. Okay, let's go deep into the Agile Manifesto. Kailangan malaman natin kung kailan ba talaga nagsimula siya at bakit nila ginawa yung Agile Manifesto. No? So, kailangan nyong malaman yun first for you to appreciate the journey. So, nagsimula siya noong February 11 to 13, year 2001. Nag-start yun with 17 people. And those 17 people have their own principles in mind. They are practicing different principles. So, nagkita-kita sila. They met in a snowbird ski resort, Utah, para to have one common goal. Ang common goal nila is they wanted to make software development easier because for those people, yung 17 people na yun, they have encountered problems to those different principles of project management. And they believe that if they brainstorm and they create something out from the similar problems that they have encountered, they might come up with something. No? Ano yung something na yun? Doon na nagsimula yung Agile Manifesto. They created an Agile Manifesto for us to follow but not strictly follow. Gets ba? So pag sinabing not strictly follow, it is only a guideline. It's only our guide for us to identify that we are doing Scrum. We are doing Agile. Okay? Kagaya na sinabi ko dun sa una kong statement a while ago. The core values of Scrum should change the mindset of your company's core values. Kasi if you are not 100% to the core values, it's difficult for us to develop with Agile approach. Remember that. So you need to change first your mindset for you to separate yourselves from your old selves. So yun yung kailangan yung matandaan na keyword. Changing yourself for us to accommodate the mindset that Agile wanted to flourish. Okay? So we will explain what are the things inside of the Agile Manifesto. So Agile Manifesto has four principles. The first one is individuals and interactions over process and tools. I-explain natin yan. We will explain that later on, one by one. No? Ano ba yung gustong sabihin sa atin ng manifesto? Ibig ba sabihin nito is tanggalin na natin yung process and tools and let's stick with individuals and interactions? So, yun yung i-explain natin later. Pero I wanted to itemize only for now kung ano ba yung apat na foundational values ng Scrum or Agile. So, the second is working software over comprehensive documentation. Next is customer collaboration over contract negotiation. Responding to change over following a plan. It has different ways, but Agile Manifesto wanted to teach us that we need to weigh more this bold letters, the core values, which I mentioned first, over the non-so core values of Agile, which is the process and tools, comprehensive documentation, contract negotiation, and following a plan, because that is the focus of the traditional approach. So we are shifting paradigm, okay? We are shifting the institution of the traditional approach, which are the ones who are mentioned on our right over on our left. So let's discuss individually, no? Ano ba talaga yung purpose nung apat na gustong ipahiwatig or gustong i-embrace natin over the others? So the first one is individual and interaction. Pag sinabing individual and interaction, the Scrum team are the highlights of the Scrum process, di ba? If the Scrum team failed, most likely, the Scrum process will fail. Remember that. The Scrum team should have the initiative to talk with themselves, to talk with the people involved, and to follow the certain guidelines that you need to collaborate with other people. Okay? Hindi siya yung task basis, ilalagay mo lang sa kanila, and then gawa lang sila ng gawa. No. The purpose of having Agile is you need to continuously collaborate, brainstorm, and you need to tap one another for you to unblock things. Okay? Do what is right, di ba? What is the right thing to do instead of what other people told you to do so. People are the center of having the business value into provision. Para mangyari yun at para magawa yung mga features na pinapagawa ni business, tao dapat yung nakasentro dun. The developers and the QAs and the Scrum Master and the Product Owner, yung focus mo dapat. Hindi yung processes, hindi yung tools. Why? Because the process and tools will always be constant, but the success of the process and tools will always be based on people and their interaction. Remember that. Hindi mag-work ng tama ang process and tools mo if the people doing the process and using the tools is hindi okay. Kaya dapat i-weigh mo or bigyan mo ng bigat yung people and interaction instead of the process and tools. Diba? It's our problem kasi sunod tayo ng sunod dun sa flow. Sunod na sunod tayo dun sa tools. Updated tayo. Updated tayo sa mga tools natin. Ang ganda ng process natin, nakalinya lahat, di ba? Naka-itemize lahat. Pero ang tanong dun yung tao ba nag-uusap? Yung mga developers mo ba nag-uusap sa QAs mo? Or baka naman sila, nagtataguan sila ng problema? Or baka naman, they are counting bugs as if they are not part of the team? O baka nagsisisihan sila na kasalanan mo to, kasalanan mo to. So, mawawala rin yung process na yun, yung ganda ng process na yun, and yung tools na ginagamit nila. If the people inside of the team are not one, I will repeat, whatever the tools and the process delivers, the most important thing pa rin is the people who uses the tools and the people inside of the process. Without the people doing their own thing, those tools and processes will fail. Remember that. Okay? Kaya dapat i-focus nyo doon sa mga tao and interaction nila. Number two, working software over, ano yung kanina? Working software or over comprehensive documentation. Diba? Focus ni Agile is magkaroon ng working software instead of magkaroon ng sobrang detalyadong documentation. Bakit? Ano ba ang importante? Yung software na gumagana o yung document na komplikado pero yung software mo hindi gumagana? So, mas priority ni Agile na magkaroon ng working software instead of napakahaba at napakadetalyadong documentation. Why? Because measuring the progress sa Agile is not on the number of hours or number of resources na na-put into mo dun sa project. Pero ang measure of success or the progress is natatapos mo ba? Or nagagamit na ba? May value na ba yung software mo? That's the most important thing inside of the Agile Manifesto. And napaka-importante rin na continuously din nagde-deliver ka ng small sprints. Okay? Yung working continuously on delivering small chunk of delivery or deliverables. Kasi kagaya na sinabi ko last vlog, hindi siya yung isang buo, hindi siya yung isang malaking bloke. Maliliit siya. Piece by piece siya dinidevelop. At piece by piece din siya binibigay kay customer. Kaya, nagagamit na nila yung isang portion ng mga bagay doon sa kanilang business process. At mas maaga mo na rin malalaman if at nagkakaroon na rin sila ng feedback. Mamaya explain natin yun. Kasi nabibigay mo continuously yung kailangan nila at yung pinakamataas na value. So, that's a number two. So, number three is customer collaboration. Customer collaboration should have three things. The first one is deliver things that has value to customers. Very important yung nagde-deliver ka ng value. Why? Because it represents something na they could use. Okay? They will appreciate more if you are delivering or you are deploying to the production the things that the customers needed. Kami, as a team, inside of a telco company, they appreciate things that we are doing because it reaps record numbers. Kumbaga, record numbers in revenue, record numbers in persons using the app. Yun yung mga masarap pakinggan. Or it's more flattering to each and every one of us that we are helping our clients to the utmost of our capabilities. So that's the first one. The second one is we should prioritize customer needs over the stipulation within our contracts. Kasi contracts are tend to be broken. Or contracts are might be biased to one party or the other. And nagiging safe yung isang entity or isang party kapag nasa contract. And Agile don't want to have that enclosure. Because the purpose of having Agile is to help one another as a team. You don't isolate yourself that to the point na ayaw mo na siyang tulungan kasi ito lang yung nasa contract ko. No. The purpose of Agile is you work as a team, you win as a team, you lose as a team. Okay? And walang liligtas because you are all accountable to the things that you are doing and to the things that you are delivering. Okay? The third one is feedback of customers play a vital role. Napaka-importante ng customer feedback because from there, you will appreciate and you will understand what are the things that they need. And, di ba, may tinatawag nga kami dun eh, na kapag the impression of the client is good, that's the time we can get more clients because our reputation will be so much more than the contract itself. Now, we are not aiming for the money, but we are aiming for the quality. And we are aiming for the betterment of the project. And we should think about, regardless if agency-based ka or in-house-based ka, you should think about like that. You should think like that na hindi ka dapat lumulusot dun sa mga bagay-bagay na alam mo naman kung ano yung tama. Okay? Kagaya na sinabi ko kanina, di ba? You must do the right thing. And you are not doing because they told you so. Okay? Sundin mo lang yung principle na yun and you will be all good and fine. Okay? So next, responding to change. Okay? If the plan doesn't sound pleasant and useful, you should change it. You need to respond to change and not follow a plan. Why? Because a plan is very linear. Okay, very traditional. Kasi ang plan is not tend to be flexible. A plan is always a plan for you to follow. Okay? So, Agile don't want you to follow a plan. But Agile wanted you to respond to the changes inside of the plan. You can use a plan. Hindi yan masama. Pero you need to accept the facts that that plan is only your guidelines, not your hard principles to stand on. Yun lang naman eh. Kailangan mo lang maging prepared. Me, as a Scrum Master, I always plan ahead. I always respond to changes through creative and imaginative forms. Kung pwede akong mag-create ng plan A, B, C, D for me to respond to changes, I will do it so. Dapat hindi ka lang nag-follow ng plan mo. Dapat you need to adapt din kung paano mag-transform yun into something kapag ka merong mga changes sa requirements, pagka merong mga changes sa mga tao mo, lalo na pag nag-resign, or lalo na kapag nagkasakit, di ba? Lalo na ngayon sa panahon na to. So, you need to respond to that kind of changes and be prepared for that. As a Scrum Master or as an Agile leader, you need to always think ahead para you have the weapons for you to respond to the changes. Kung hindi nag-work yung plans mo, change it. That's how easy it is, right? Change it or create another one ahead of time. Then, huwag ka matakot sa mga changes. Natural yan. It's part of life. Kaya lang sinabi nila, change is inevitable. So, the only constant in the world is change. Kaya dapat, tanggalin mo na yung mindset mo dun sa traditional approach na black and white. Dapat you are responding to change. Okay? So, let's go with the misconception about Agile. Nalaman na natin kung ano ba yung dapat natin i-priority over the other principles, no? So, ngayon, makikita natin kung ano yung misconception naman sa Agile. Ito yung lang yung mga iilan, no? Makikita nyo dito, nakasulat na, ang daming sangay or ang daming hierarchical organizational chart nila, di ba? Kitang-kita nyo, napakadami, di ba? Ang daming segments. Pero, isa lang dun, yung naka-agile. And this little red thing is our agile project. Kita nyo? Sa tingin nyo, mag-work ba to? Do you think it will work if only one team has an agile mindset? Sort of not. Why? Because if we are thinking about a mindset and we are thinking about transformation, we will not be an agile if it is only revolving on one team. Remember that. Kung hindi supported ng buong company yung pagiging agile nyo, it would be very difficult for us to implement agile. Why? Because it is a mindset. A mindset of many, not a mindset of few. Bakit? Kakainin ka lang ng ibang mga mindset, lalo na yung mga traditional, they will keep on asking you why you are doing this and why you are doing that, no? That's the struggle, no? I have worked with a lot of people na they have this old mindset pa rin. And it's difficult to discuss each and every day regarding how you should think, how you should act, no? Ang hirap. So, for me, that's a misconception na subukan muna natin dito sa maliit na ano na to, na grupo na to. And let's see if it will work. Yeah, it will work. Pero you need to support that sooner or later. Hindi dapat isa lang yung mag-work. Ang hirap niyan. Kasi gusto mo nga mawala yung funnel, yung imbudo na from one team, papasa sa team mo, papasa mo naman doon sa ito. Very waterfall yung ganun eh. So gusto mo collaborative lahat. So you're embracing each and every one eh, to support your goal. So dapat you wanted to transform, you should transform as a company or as a department for you to remove all of the blockers of the waterfall approach, no? Or the linear approach. Ito yung isa. And we've tripled the story points per sprint, right? Triple the story points per sprint. Bakit naging triple? Kasi lahat almost done. A big no-no. Almost is not done. Remember that. Almost is not done. Okay? Kagaya ng sinabi ko kanina, the second Agile Manifesto is working software over comprehensive documentation. You should have working software. almost done is not a working software, 100% working software. Okay? So, dapat done yan. Diba? Dapat tapos yan. Hindi dapat yung almost done. Okay? You can't attribute the story points if it is not done. Okay? So, para sa akin, burn points lang siya. Pero yung total actual points na dapat dun is not on the verge of having it done. So, kaya kung ako sa inyo, you count the story points based on what you have done. Almost done is not a magic word. Ang magic word is done lang. Okay? So next, that's not agile. Hindi daw agile. It's waterfall with stand-ups. Yan, meron tayong mga tinatawag na scrumfall. Yun yung waterfall na pretending to be scrum or pretending to be agile. Maraming ganyan. Magkaroon lang ng scrum team, magkaroon lang ng mga activities. Scrum na yung tawag nila or agile na yung tawag nila. Pero wala namang mindset. Hindi naman tama yung mindset nila. So hindi pa rin siya scrum. Right? Kasi sabi nga nila, people and interactions over process and tools. Diba? Having a process, a scrum process, doesn't make you a scrum or doesn't make you an agile. But the agile mindset will do. Kaya kung ako sa inyo, maganda yan, may process kayo, pero you need to change your mindset pa rin. Hindi dapat nagtatapos yung crusade nyo. Having an agile transformation doon sa process itself, you need to have a clear vision that people should act as one, should collaborate as one, and should be transparent as one. So, oh, you meet stand-up. Sabi dito sa pangalawa, no? You must be so agile. Diba? It doesn't make you an agile, again, if you have processes involved. Mindset will treat you as agile. Okay, ganun dapat yung mindset. Then, the next one is, will ask for estimates and then treat them as deadlines. Diba? Ano yung sinabi kanina? Hindi nagka-count sa number of hours ng tao mo or gaano ba karami yung tao mo kung agile ba yun or hindi. Nagmamatter dapat yun kung ano yung nade-deliver ng tao mo. The value, not on the deadlines, not on the number of features that you need to deliver. It should be the value you are delivering to the business. Keep that in mind. So, to wrap it all up, Agile Manifesto is a guideline for you to understand the mindset, for you to understand the prerequisite before doing the Scrum processes. Okay? You need to understand how you should think, how you should feel, and how you should implement things. If you as a boss, you don't have those qualities and you don't have priorities over the first statements that I've mentioned in the Agile Manifesto, if you as a transformation leader don't prioritize the Agile Manifesto, so I think you can't implement Agile as a whole sense of it. But if you prioritize the Agile Manifesto as it should be, I think it would be a better deliverables for you to come. So remember that na yun na isang guidelines that you need to follow. But after you change the mindset already, it's easier for you to build your own kind of agile. Kaya dapat you should appreciate and you should implement first the mindset before the process itself. Okay? It's okay to have the process first, but you need to ensure that the mindset will always be part of it. Okay? So, next week, we will have another one. Ituturo ko na sa inyo kung paano maging certified Scrum Master. And malalaman nyo kung bakit inuna ko yung dalawa before I teach you on how to become a Scrum Master. Okay? So, remember the Agile Manifesto and its worth. And the mindset is very important for you to implement Agile. Without the mindset, Agile will be dead. So, kung nagustuhan niyo itong topic na to, please like, share, and subscribe sa channel natin para mas maparami pa natin itong ka-t-shirts natin. And thank you pala doon sa mga nag-comment na you loved and you wanted to have more Scrum 101 videos. I will surely and gladly provide you one. But hope you can share this to your friends as well if they wanted to have a change of career or they wanted to pursue having a Scrum Master career. So maraming salamat sa mga nanood and hopefully you will be with me on the next T-Shirt Guy vlog.